Let's say this should be my router. My router is also a switch, meaning it has various Ethernet ports where I can connect devices to. The router is connected to the internet over the WAN port, and between the router and the internet I have a firewall. That firewall has different zones. Let's call them LAN, IoT, guest, and WAN. I can now define traffic rules. For example, I want to allow internet for my guests, but they should not be able to connect to my devices in the LAN. The IoT devices, on the other hand, such as my IP cameras or my vacuum cleaner, should be blocked from internet access. A normal LAN user should have internet access and also be able to access the IoT devices. I can create multiple Wi-Fis or SSIDs and assign them to the right firewall zone. This way, a user connecting to a specific Wi-Fi will always be mapped to the right firewall zone. But I can, of course, also assign Ethernet interfaces to the firewall zones. If I had two physical interfaces on my router, it would create two physical LANs and assign one to the LAN ports of the switch and one to the internet port of the switch. If I have only one internet interface in my router, it would do the same thing, but rather than creating a physical LAN, it would create a virtual LAN, a VLAN. It does this by adding sub-interfaces to the existing Ethernet interface and mapping VLAN 1 to Ethernet 0.1 and VLAN 2 to Ethernet 0.2. So in fact, you might already have VLANs on your router without even knowing. You are not limited to two VLANs, but you can create many more. And you can map each of these to one or more ports on your switch. In our case, we create a third interface, Ethernet 0.3, assign it to the IoT firewall zone and map it to a port on the switch. We do the same thing with VLAN 4 and map it to another port on the switch and to the guest network. If I connected the PC to the green port, it would receive an IP address from the LAN interface and be assigned to the right firewall zone. If I connected to the red port, it would be in the IoT zone. You do not need a router to do this. A managed switch can do exactly the same thing. It can map Ethernet ports to VLANs. You can only have one VLAN per switch port, which is logical because you can only connect one device to it and the device doesn't know about VLANs, and we don't tell it about it either. Or, in other words, the ports are untagged. But what if I want to transfer multiple VLANs over one cable? For example, extend my guest Wi-Fi to a second access point. In this case, I can assign all three VLANs to one single port, but I have to tag them. The device that is connected to a tagged port needs to understand VLAN tagging in order to redistribute the signals to the right interfaces. My router can understand tagging, so it's able to dispatch a device that is connected to the managed switch to the right interface and hence to the right firewall zone. In the next episode, we will build a managed switch from an old scrap Wi-Fi router and do the examples which I have shown here in OpenWRT. Stay tuned, stay healthy, bye for now.